we have a physics question that says study the circuit, this circuit here. Find the PD across resistor R1, this R1 here. When they say the circuit, it's a diagrammatical representation of the flow of electricity. Now, this circuit is made up of different components. This one you are seeing here, it is the batteries which are producing what is 20 voltage. This line, it is the wire where electricity flows. These three components are the resistor, which are responsible for resistance here. When they say PD, simply means potential difference, which is just the other name for voltage, the driving force, okay? Now, the question here says, find the PD, meaning the voltage across the resistor R1. This here. They want us to find the voltage passing through this component here. Now, you need to understand that the first step, we need to find the total resistance. So the total resistance will be found like this. You say this one total, it is equal to R1 times R2 over R1 plus what? R2, you say plus R3 there. Okay, we say equal. What is R1? It is 3. So you put 3, you say times. What is R2? R2, it is 6. You put 6 over. What is R1? It is 3. You say plus. What is R2? R2, it is 6 there. You say plus. What is R3? It is 2, which is here. You put 2. Now, from here, you know it will be like this. So, 3 times 6, it is 18. 3 plus 6, it is 9. So, 9 into 18, it is 2. So, it will be now 2 from here. You say plus 2. Plus 2, which will give me what? 4 ohms, like that. Now, you need to keep in mind that we use this formula when the components, they are in what? Parallel. Plus the one which is in what? In a series, meaning in a straight line there. This 4, it is representing the total ohms for this one, the total resistor for these three components there. But our interest is to find the voltage. Now, for us to find the voltage, we need to find the current which is flowing through the circuit. So we say now, we say current, it is equal to what? Voltage over what? Over the total resistance, which is equal. What is the voltage? The total, it is 20. So you put 20 over. What is the combined resistance? It is 4. Like this. So 4 into 20, it is 5 ampere. So 5 ampere, it is the one which is the current which is flowing through the what? The circuit there. But our interest is to find the what? The voltage. Now, how can we find the voltage? So for us to find the voltage, we need to get this one here. So it is now 5A, which is the current, multiply with what? With 2. So when we multiply with 2, it's going to give me what? 10 volt. This 10 volt, it is the one which is for this one. This 2, it is the resistor for this one here. So this 10, it is the voltage for R3, resistor 3 there. Now, since we know that the total voltage in the circuit, it is 20. Out of 20, they have said this 10, it is for R3. Now, how about for these two here? For us to find for these two, we need to subtract. So, it will be now 20, which is the total, minus 10 for this one here. So, it is like this. So, which will give me what? 10 voltage. This 10 voltage, it is the one which is for R1 and for R2. Why so? Remember what I said at first. When the components are in parallel, it simply means they have the same voltage. So meaning this 10, it is for R1. Again, the same 10, it is for R2. So the final answer should be what? 10 volt there.